Today, this is L6 lecture of formal language and automata theory. So I think this is, I already explained, this is the alphabet. This alphabet is a finite set and it consists of symbols. It may consist of 0, 1 or small a, b or a, b, c, d, e, f, g. These are symbols. Remember the whenever we say a, b, c, they are the single symbol, and whenever we now our subsequent subsequent proof, we will see use u, v, w, x, y, z. They generally not a single symbol but consist of a arrays of symbols. So small, from a, b, c, d, they are the single symbol, and this is the alphabet. And whenever you know the alphabet, we write it by sigma, and sigma star means any combination of a, b. And the sentences is whenever it's a meaningful combination of a, b, we call it a sentence. Sentence can be formed by some grammar. The grammar, I will tell what is about grammar. So we can say this is a sentence. Sentence means, but definitely the subset of sigma star. And these are the rules of the grammar. Here also the regular grammar. I'll complete what is regular grammar, because regular grammar, finite state machine, non-deterministic finite state machine and regular expressions, all are equivalent to each other, 1:1. So every finite state machine can have only one regular language. You can one-to-one identify to it, and that only one regular language can have only one regular grammar. This is the grammar portion. The grammar consists a start symbol like s, and it can has it's a variable, and it consists of right hand side one only terminal. If it is one, or if it is two, a variable and terminal. If it is a variable, if it is at the end, it is called a right linear grammar, because all are right linear grammar. Here are all right linear grammar. So we'll discuss about this later. Next slide I'll cover. This is the basic finite state machine. Michael Sifser's book, I have followed it. This is basic Michael Sifser's book. This I have already explained. This is a particular FSM which can detect the any language which has three consecutive ones. So, and always a start state is a five tuple. Start state should be indicated by a single arrow, and accepted state or final state. There are two names in different books. Some books say it's accepted or some final state. Say if it is all our final states, then anything is accepted in the language, then we call sigma star is the language. But here only one state is accept state or final state, and so this is the language. Any strings of ones, it will be accepted, and after it goes to one, if any zero and ones, it always accepted. You can call it a trap state sort of thing. And all this documentation I have taken from MIT Edu site. You can get it. This I have covered my lecture 5. I have covered my lecture 5 here. Nothing is say I used to mention that a finite state machine is a basic machine by a computer scientist have done it, and which can be titillated or which can be excited by a definite. Every finite state machine has one-to-one a language is there, not many language, and that language you can write programs, so that not usual programs whatever see, but in language you can write some instructions to titillate or to get excitation from this machine. And this machine, if you put a strings from left to right, if it starts from Q0, it must go to final state. If it doesn't go, if at the end of the string it doesn't go, then we said this string is not accepted. The string is not in the language. If the strings from I put it, say strings consist of A, B, C, I put it, and if I consist a final state or accepting state, and then you will say the language is accepted. So remember this, every finite state machine has only one and only language, and that language we will call it a regular language. Regular language we are all used in our Unix command, like there you get some, say ls start dot c, star is a regular expressions command. Star means anything can come that is regular expression, or which file starts with a star dot c, like star, this is regular expression. So these regular expressions, regular language, finite state machine, deterministic finite state machine, and non-deterministic finite state machine, that I will cover. They are all same, but whenever the non-deterministic finite state machine is only useful whenever you are designing for deterministic finite state machine. Sometimes deterministic finite state machine is difficult to construct non-deterministic finite state machine is easy, you can construct on paper, not in actual hardware. Then from non-deterministic finite state machine, you convert to deterministic finite state machine, and then hardware will be easier, and then a regular language, remember what is regular language, the set of strings which can be accepted on that machine are same. So let's see. So this is the machine, and regular language is called L of M. Sigma star I have called it all of finest radius. So this I have covered. So what I was taking the last class. Here, this is a five tuple. This is a finite, this is a finite, this is a Cartesian product or pair, and this goes to a cube. Okay, and f is the, if may be a single state or it may be number of state. If f doesn't have any state, no state, then nothing is accepted. The language will be shy. So, language will not be nil, it will be shy. Shy means nothing is accepted in that finite state machine. Yeah, this is the Michael Sifson's book definition. Please follow this book. This is one of the excellent book. Here it is also this, the final state it mentioned, I covered last. And transition function, say here the concept after delta x is y. Yes, it is, I have covered last class. Yeah, this is one interesting thing, that is a, this is a finite state machine, and you can describe delta, the delta that is transition function, by this table or diagram or both. So this is a transition function table, and you can have a one more diagram, you can do it. Okay, so these are the way you can describe finite state machine. This is some books it is called delta hat, some book is called delta star. Delta star or delta hat, it means subsequent application of delta function. So like you, if you have a start state q, and this is a w, is I have told you it is a string, it is not a single character. So delta star q means delta star q means what? Delta star, it is delta star. In some books it is called delta hat. Delta hat means repeated applications or q, and it's a w consists of say bc, the first delta qb, then qc, the whole combination I call it delta star qw, and then you apply qa, so that's it. So it's a multiple application of delta, delta star, multiple application of delta. In some books it is called delta hat. So it is a repeated application of transition function. String is accepted if it's final state, that is if it's yes, string w rejected, I have told again and again, and those is rejected, those type of string is not the language of that finite state machine. A language is any set of string over some alphabet, and beauty of it, the with language which can be accepted, it can be really explicitly written by regular expression. Regular expression, I come to that. Regular expression is something like you always use in the whenever you find wildcard and all this in our Unix command, or even in the DOS commands also, the star is there. A language, any set of strings is accepted. A language is regular or finite automata recognizable or acceptable. Both terms is there. It will be some finite automata. This is I have covered. Does I mean and contains 101 as a substring? Yes, this is tricky. So they are covered. This I also covered. This chap state. This I also covered. Today I start, because these are all covered in lecture 4. This is Michael Sif's that I've also covered about earlier book, earlier class. Yeah, this is, I intentionally take it from Dexter Partisan Books, Automata and Complexity. This book, Softcopy, is fully available with you. What I want to show the definition of the best examples of books, so that ultimately they are same. Sometimes their language is bit different here. All languages, yes, see, Sif says book it is Q0, here it is S, but it is same. Sigma is almost is alphabet, and the transition function here also. So you should not be, whenever you see new book, if you see new term, you don't be confused. It is better to have 2-3 version you should know. It's accepted and fine. This is Kotzen book. This is also famous book. Definition of deterministic finite automata. This is Hopcroft book. I'll just again give it a Hopcroft book. Everywhere it is a 5-tuple. This finite automata I have already covered. Language, I must say, the any finite state machine can have one-to-one correspondence only one regular language. What is regular language? I'll come. Yeah, this slide I have earlier covered. This is finite automata, regular language. Regular language always a very left hand side should be a single variable, and right hand side a terminal, or a terminal and a variable, or a variable and terminal, but both cannot be there. Left hand side should be either a terminal or terminal and a variable, then called right linear grammar. And if it is a first a terminal and variable and then terminal, then it's a left linear grammar. But in a grammar means consist of rules. Both left linear grammar and right linear grammar should not be there. If it is there, then it is not regular language, it is higher language. We will know that is called that is a context free grammar and deterministic context free grammar, or higher grammar. Then your finite state machine will fail to recognize that language. But your finite state machine, however complicated it is, it must be identified one regular language. And regular language is nothing but consists of variables, terminals, and rules. And I'll cover this. And regular expressions also same. So all are same. That is the beauty of it. And a lot of computation job can be done. Like whenever you write program in a C language or Java language, whenever in the first stage, we have to get tokens out of it. So say you write variable integer, say i1 integer equal to i1 2. So all this declaration is taken by a token, and it is done by a deterministic finite state machine only. No Turing machine, no Poisson automata. So for any programming languages which is to be compiled or interpreted, so all the first pass is always done by a finite state machine, which takes out the tokens of your variable name, and whatever the variable name, you have give it token. That's it. So that is a very useful purpose of, one of the useful purpose of finite state machine. Yes, this is, I give you what is the example of regular expression. See, any programming language is identified, can be later should come once, then anything later or digit together, any star means it is a any occurrence, number of occurrence. So this is a diagram. This is, you call it a regular expression. This is a regular expression, and this is, you can call it a finite state machine sort of thing. So first star should be a letter, and then any combination of letter and digit, say any combination of letter or digit. So this is a example of regular expression. A strong relationship between finite automata and regular expression is this. Here you see there must traverse A, so that is a start and this is a end. A B, there's a E and terminal A B, it should be concatenated. A or B, that means from here you can go A, and from here one state to one state you can go by B. A star means repeated application zero or more. That is a regular expression. It is called a repeated application. What is regular expression? Regular expression, short form is regex, describes a set of possible input string. Regular expression descends from a fundamental concept of computer science called finite automata theory. You all use VI, edit, set, awk, this wave compilers, even your DOS command. If you see DIR, which are those commands starts for DIR, f start dot c, what in with c program. So the f start dot c is a regular expression. Whenever you use star, this is a regular expression. Yeah, this is a fantastic example from Michael Sipser. This is one of the toughest areas of first part. It is not tough. Deterministic computation, which is whatever we have discussed, it is always a deterministic, that it cannot go. Another is non-deterministic computation. Non-deterministic computation means it is same as this, but it from with its transition, say if you give a zero, it can go here or here, either or, and it may either, but at the end, if it is accepted, it is accepted. So, as if, but here, this non-deterministic computation is very, very difficult to realize in hardware, but it is very, very easy to realize in your notation or notation, so that it is much shorter than finite state machine. And one great thing is any non-deterministic finite state machine can be converted to deterministic computation, and that is also, if it is a minimum state for any non-deterministic computation, can be converted with minimum state deterministic finite state machine. So, but what is the purpose of it? It is easier to accept the regular expressions. So, we catch the requirement by regular expression. From regular expression, it might be easy to design a non-deterministic finite state machine. And what is non-deterministic finite state machine? It can go any random path. It can epsilon transition also. Epsilon means it can jump to any transition, and but at the end, if it is accepted, it is accepted. If at the end it is not accepted, don't know, it is not accepted. So, it, if at the end any path, if it got accepted, like some kind of OR you can see, not AND. So, if anyway it is accepted, it is accepted. Okay, this is Michael Sipser's book, yeah. So, just introduction to non-deterministic finite automata, general finite automata adding non-determinism, allowing several alternative computations on the same input string. Ordinary deterministic follow one path on each, that is, so deterministic means only one and only one path. And here, to specify more than one success, so from state Q with A, you can go here or here. And there is no probability factor, it can go 100% here or it may go 100% here. There are no associated probability with this, and epsilon or some books get lambda, but in fact there is, it can jump lambda transition, there is no input at all, but it can jump at lambda transition made for free without consuming any input symbol. So one can, but there should be a path in that from Q1 to Q2 with epsilon transition, it can jump. Finally, combine these changes. Then formal definition of NFA. NFA is again a 5 tuple, but here this is will be changed. This is Q is a finite state, sigma finite. This is, these are same with the basic deterministic finite state machine, but here see, here is a Q. Now it is a Cartesian product with a sigma with epsilon also, not with all, even epsilon into PQ. This is PQ is a not Q, it is a power set. So it can go any set. So it is a power set bit, it can go any combination of set. Okay, so Q0 is the start state and F is in the set of accepting or final state. So, this is the definition of NFA. Okay, so any confusion, please. So, we will continue with this. Thank you for viewing.